This tutorial is going to show you how to make a few more interesting graphics in Premiere. My next tutorial is going to show you how to do this in Photoshop and then import it in, which gives you much more control and much more capability than using Premiere alone. So just using Premiere, this is basically what you can do. There's a few options, but here's one. So this is a lower third that slides in. You know, it looks pretty good, but it's not great. Of course, obviously I'm not spending too much time on this. You can get some good looking pieces in here. But you can see that there's only so much complexity you can get. Then here's one with Photoshop. So what I want you to notice about this one is that it seems like it's just as simple. It's just we have a more complex shape here. But when you really look at it, you can actually see that the text is cut out. So it's lighter here and darker here, which means that you can use transparency using Photoshop in a way that you can't use it with Premiere. So you can get some really complex interplay. Let's say there was a video behind this, you would see the video through the CMC Productions logo, which often gives you a very beautiful or sophisticated look. So I'm going to show you how to do the first part of this, and then my next tutorial will show you how to do the second part of this. So this is actually not that hard. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to make a graphic here, a lower third graphic, and it's going to look basically like this. This is pretty simple. All I've done is made two pieces here, so I'll do it again so I can show you. I'm going to use my wedge tool to create a sharp point here, and you can see the fill color is green. If I want to change this, I can, so let's change it to blue, let's say. And then I use the same color, and I do it with a rectangle. So I'm going to make it bigger than I need so that I can slide it over and put it on top of the rectangle. Now, this is not really very exact. It's not the best way to do this, because you can see there's a little bit of an edge. It's a little higher here, a little lower here. And it's just difficult to get it to be exact in Premiere. It's much, much easier in Photoshop or Illustrator if you're an Illustrator user. But, you know, it's adequate for our needs here. I'm going to go ahead and delete these out so that we can keep the title that we've got. And the other title that you want to do is just a text title that says CMC Productions. So here I've got CMC Productions, and it's just text, no drop shadow, nothing. Nothing's been added here. You can, of course, add a drop shadow. You can add a stroke, all of those kinds of things. A stroke you might want to do, whatever. But I wouldn't do opacity or anything like that in this case. I would actually use the controls in the main section of Premiere rather than the ones in the title. The same thing with shadows. I would use the drop shadow effect. So I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm going to drag that lower third graphic onto my screen. And you can see it looks pretty clumsy there. But don't worry about that yet. Then I'm going to drag my productions thing on top of it. I'm going to offset this a little bit. So my productions piece, I'm going to drag down so that it looks like a lower third should. So about here. And then my lower third graphic, I'm going to use my piece here so that it doesn't, since this one's above it, it won't see it, or it won't select it correctly. So I'm going to drag on the y-axis down so that it is right below CMC Productions. So that looks basically like I want it, but I might actually have it about here so that this isn't quite so startling. So once this is done, you know, I could just have this appear. So it appears and appears on top of it, and you're fine. You could cross-dissolve that on, and it wouldn't look too bad. But I want to show you a little bit more complexity. So in this case, what I'm going to do is I know I want this green thing to end up right here. So I'm going to animate my position, and it's going to leave it here. And then I'm going to go to the beginning and drag the x-axis off so that it's actually off of the screen here. So that when it plays, it will actually slide in. And then I get to my CMC Productions thing. And it's the same thing here. I'm going to, let's say I want to be at 100 opacity here. So when I'm on the title there, I will add a keyframe in opacity. And then I'm going to go back to the beginning. And I'm going to reduce the opacity to 0. So here I have it slide in. And then I have CMC Productions fade onto the screen. I also want drop shadows just so it looks a little bit more complex. So what I'm going to do is go to my effects, type in drop, and that's going to give me my drop shadow effect, and I'm going to drag it onto my text, onto the copy here. Drop shadow is default a little clumsy, so I'm going to increase the distance to around 20, and I'm going to increase the softness, which is very important, to around 40 or so, 45. And you can see it gives a very subtle little shadow here at the end. The cool thing about doing it on the title instead of in the title is that once you click on this and copy, you can paste it right on your graphic. So I'm going to paste it on here so that I have the same exact shadow on the graphic itself. So we have a shadow onto the background, and then we have the shadow from the copy onto this piece. So it gives you a really nice three-dimensional look here. So this is a pretty simple way to make a pretty attractive-looking title. Tune in next time for the more complex Photoshop piece.